Hi guys! Today I'll show you a new aesthetic I stumbled across. Well, not new, I just found it when I was looking for material for my other videos. I got from vaporwave to aesthetic edits, vent art and these Pinterest boards that caught my attention. They all had this cool and soothing look and they were all in purple. So I asked myself, what's behind vent art and why use purple? But before we get into it, I want to preface this by saying I tried to keep the video more brief this time, but like with any topic that captures my attention, that's probably doomed to fail. I also predict the inevitable downfall of my analysis here. Simplifying complex ideas is a daunting task, and it often can do more harm than good, but here I am. I also won't go into detail about the contents in all of the works, I'll just give an overview and focus on why exactly purple is used in so many of them. Alright then, let's get started. Alright, before anyone says anything, I want to make clear that vent art is a very touchy subject for many people. I know I can't please everyone, so I won't try to act like I have the correct explanation to what vent art is and how it helps people, but I can try to give you my viewpoint. To put it roughly, vent art is a type of coping mechanism or a way to express oneself for people that need an outlet for their feelings. And more often than not, this includes depictions of trauma like self-harm or abuse. And that's why some people feel uncomfortable seeing vent art posted online, which poses the central question around vent art's controversy. If the therapeutic effect of it lies wholly in its creation and doesn't have to be posted, or if the act of sharing one's experience is part of the healing process. And I don't have the answer to that, you gotta figure it out for yourself. By putting your personal struggles onto a page, you're taking it out of yourself and putting it into a new medium, which makes it less personal or less real, I'd say. Which helps in the process of trauma. It's an act of abstraction. One argument for the posting of vent art is the breaking of this stigma of mental health by sharing it and relating. Most people, especially children, are unable to openly talk about their emotions and mental health with others, again due to its stigma in our society. This way, I think vent art can be seen as confiding in someone or screaming into the void of the internet. It's a form of catharsis. It's about manifesting emotions in a safe way. Author Warren Desmond puts it like this: art and true expression aren't about suppressing your appetite for everything morbid. They're about channeling that appetite responsibly. It's not a question of how to keep your inner demons at bay, more like, why should you? It's a well-accepted notion that repression of parts of yourself isn't healthy. We find ourselves free to explore anything through various artistic mediums, and we know that once we put it there, it will stay put. Instead of playing a hellish game of psychological whack-a-mole, constantly trying to beat our inner demons back down lest they make a dangerous escape, we can put their ideas into our art and let them remain there. Other forms of vent art I found are things like vent playlists on YouTube or TraumaCore. See, it all comes around. Here too, people share their experiences and confide in one another in the comments. The repression of the dark side is a denial of the dual self. It seems only fitting then to express this dual state in a visual form using the dual nature of purple. We'll get to that. Some adjacent works to this topic are paintings containing the dual self by Peter Berghäuser, or a more popular example of traditional vent art by the Polish artist Zdzisław Bekszynski, who processed his experiences in World War II through his paintings. Some of you may know him as the nightmare artist on YouTube. I'll link a video to both artists in the description. Trying to get to the core of the subject, we gotta make a distinction. The aesthetic can be divided into many subcategories. It ranges from pics with sparkling overlays and classic nostalgic edits over the bubble of ghosts and demons all the way to the vent art corner with darker posts. From the more lighthearted pics, you can still feel the strong influence of vaporwave and other nostalgia trends currently on the rise. The most common association here are neon lights, the echo of a party, the soft colors draping the image like a foggy recollection of a once-known place, a distant memory. This link to all the movements like vaporwave gives purple this association of being the color of nostalgia. Then there are the pictures of demons, ghosts, and skeletons. Here the aforementioned fascination with the morbid becomes apparent. This is also where the aesthetic overlaps with a few others, the ghost image bubble also existing outside the purple influence. The use of the paranormal puts the images in out of the norm context. It establishes the creators themselves as deviants of some sorts. And deviancy is a common theme in the images. Other major themes inside the purple movement are lost love and heartbreak, as well as a fear of abandonment, and probably the biggest out of them all, loneliness. All of them are parts of the adolescent experience. Many images incorporate drugs too, as they depict the chosen coping mechanism for the mentioned problems. In my opinion, in a historic sense, they all show a very romantic or idealized view of the world, where virtues like loyalty, honesty, and devotion are valued. It also shows the betrayal of these values by the outside world, leading to a disillusionment with modern life. This ultimately leads into a rebellion against the absurd. In a way, the aesthetic embodies the philosophy of absurdism popularized by French philosopher Albert Camus. By accepting the inherent absurdity of the world, one can achieve the greatest extent of one's freedom. By recognizing no religious or other moral constraints, and by rebelling against the absurd while accepting it as unstoppable, one can find contentment in the process. And this is also fittingly described by fellow philosopher Søren Kierkegaard as a demoniac madness. What I got from these images was a feeling of confiding in someone, being part of an underground or rebellious group against the mainstream. There are many reasons for this and why purple is the perfect fit for this effect, but we'll get to that in a minute. A word in many of the edits is an overarching theme of generational trauma. Teenage angst and depression are being converted and translated into an artistic expression, becoming a shared experience. In a way, it's a form of the commodification of one's identity and struggles. In other words, social media. And in fact, this isolation and solitary feeling apparent in the pictures is often cited as a byproduct or consequence of parasocial relationships, which get cultivated through social media. Now, why is purple used to convey all this? To start off, purple is the color of ambiguity and the artificial. Its scarcity in nature also makes it the color of mystery and the supernatural, think witchcraft or magic. It's the color of transition in dawn and dusk, times of change, giving it both a tranquil and vaguely energetic presence, a duality that winds itself through the aesthetic itself. And the dual nature is a big thing with purple. It's a combination of red and blue, red's energy and intensity, and blue's calm, stability, and authority. The artificiality of the color stems from its imaginary nature as well as its rarity and cultural connotations. Used in a party setting, it's the manifestation of the artificial, unnatural lighting. It's a deviant presence. And like I mentioned, this leads back to vaporwave and purple's cultural association with nostalgia. But how many of you will know the most common association of purple is royalty, church, and power in general? I'll skip over this for the sake of conciseness. Just know that it was a very rare color, only donned by members of royalty or high status within the church or the Roman Empire, till it was synthesized by William Henry Perkin. All this culminates into purple being also a color of allure and corruption, but I'll skip this too because there already is an excellent piece on this done by Razbuten, link in the description. And this might be a stretch, but in my opinion, the usage of the color by the unheard masses thus becomes an act of rebellion, giving the color an air of counterculture by defying or criticizing royalty, religion, and this straying from authority. Speaking of counterculture, purple is also heavily associated with the psychedelic drug culture of the 1960s and 70s. Jimi Hendrix's ambiguous song Purple Haze is often interpreted as referring to a psychedelic experience and constitutes a time of social, musical, and artistic change. The fascination with psychedelics never really left, and in this case it's getting processed in the artworks. In Prince's famous song Purple Rain from 84, the color is given an apocalyptic connotation. When there's blood in the sky, like Prince said, purple, the mix of red and blue, becomes a harbinger of the end times. And the nihilistic aspect of this is drawn out by the new aesthetic, combining the color with demonic and ghostly imagery, giving off a careless end-of-the-world vibe and closing the loop with the themes of deviancy and rebellion of the youth. Within the aesthetic, purple is used as a tool to detach and distance oneself, an aloof and isolated position that in itself holds a kind of power, power over the self, a self-determined life, something that the aesthetic puts forth as an ideal. Coming back to counterculture, purple was also used as a symbol of unconventionality and artistic brilliance. Icons like Prince, David Bowie, and Jimi Hendrix brought the color to Western pop culture, making it an expression of individuality. Ironically, this gets subverted by the homogeneous use by all the people partaking in the purple aesthetic. The color itself loses its individual aspect and becomes a form of collective expression. That too, I think, can be a sign of unity and mutual understanding. In the US, the Purple Heart is one of the highest honors for bravery in military service. The award was created in 1782 by George Washington to honor a soldier's commendable actions. Here the color represents courage and bravery. A fascinating side note, purple or magenta doesn't actually exist. There's not a purple wavelength that lies outside our visible spectrum. We need a mix of blue and red to create it. The closest we get to true purple is violet, which lies at the very end of the visible spectrum. There's a video about it, and I linked it in the description. I think an interesting take on purple also comes from an article on color theory. Purple is the compassionate soul, the introvert. It assists in spiritual fulfillment and transformation of the soul. And although the color purple enhances our spiritual enlightenment and relates to daydreaming and escaping from reality, it also keeps us grounded. This reaffirms what we see in the aesthetic, the rejection of social norms and attempt of escaping reality. Purple, seen as a cousin color of pink, is often associated with floral themes and femininity, but purple can also be seen as the corruption of pink, subverting girlhood and girliness. It's the color of tainted love. Speaking of flowers, let's talk about violets for a moment. Violets have been associated with lesbian love since the 6th century, citing Greek poet Sappho, who centered much of her poetry around the relationship and love between women, who she often described as wearing garlands of violets. And violets as a symbol of lesbian love rose again in 1926 when Edouard Bourdet's play The Captive showed a female character sending another woman violets. When the play led to public outcry and calls for boycott and censorship, some women wore violets to show their support. The color of violets and lavender was also used as a way to describe gay or effeminate men in the turn of the 20th century. Historian Carl Sandburg, for instance, wrote that Abraham Lincoln had a streak of lavender and spots soft as May violets. And although the symbolism of the actual flowers faded with time, the purple color would come to represent LGBT empowerment in later years. In the 60s and 70s, activists wore lavender during events that included a march to commemorate the Stonewall riots. Purple's duality is fitting for the aesthetic. It sits on the threshold of many others like cryptidcore or other ghostly aesthetics, and while I can't say for certain whether one aesthetic came before the others, it's safe to say they influenced each other a great bit. The fragile and feminine elements in the purple aesthetic get converted into a strength, a kind of wall, fuck all this mentality. Maybe it's an attempt of saying feminine traits aren't weak, a statement embodying the girl boss mentality. The threshold poses another interesting train of thought. In itself, it signifies not wanting to commit to either side, not defining oneself as one definite thing. It's a rejection of absolutes. Maybe by using purple, the people creating these posts are expressing their dilemma of their uncertain, ambiguous state. Or maybe they are purposely placing themselves on this threshold as to give themselves a sense of empowerment, be it only in their choice to abstain from commitment. Trying to tie the knot with what I said earlier about violets, purple draws a bridge between identity or self-identity and sexuality, and does so in a confrontational manner. As sexuality can be said to be part of awakening as an adolescent, the usage of purple in these instances can be interpreted as another kind of rebellion, a break with the gender norm often symbolized with pink and blue. The darker parts of the aesthetic, tied with band art and the aspects of depression and anxiety, can be seen as a generational split, the color purple symbolizing the rift. Depression itself is often depicted with the color blue. Now, feeling blue is repurposed as feeling purple. It's an expression of exactly that feeling of dread mixed with the ambiguity and uncertainty of youth and the rapid changes it entails. Now, I've been going on about a color for long enough. Take away from it whatever you want, and if you have any other ideas or your own thoughts or interpretations, just share them in the comments. A huge thank you to all the new viewers out there. Since I uploaded my last essay, we've gone from under 100 subs to like almost 3000 now. Like, that's crazy. Honestly, the support is incredible. I'll try to give back to all of you guys, and if you have any other video recommendations you want to see, just let me know in the comments. All right, that's it. Peace. Yeah, all the bullshit is adding up. And these fake